Up till now, we have studied structure of seed and germination of seed. Now we're going to study the different stages of seed germination. So as you can see in this figure, the first picture shows a seed which has a seed coat. Then in the second one, we can see that the embryo root, or it is also known as radical, it pushes the seed coat. Then slowly the radical goes down into the soil and it forms the roots. So we can see here the roots are being formed over here. Then the cotyledon is being pulled upwards and the baby plant or the seedling starts coming out of the cotyledons. So we can see here that it is coming out of the cotyledons, and this part is nothing but the plumule which has come out of the soil. So the plumule or the stem grows above the soil and the leaves appear first. Next, leaves develop completely. You can see in the last figure that the leaves have developed completely and the cotyledons fall off. Thus, the process of germination is completed. Now we still have to see two more concepts, that is two more concepts or the terms like epicotyl and hypocotyl. So hypocotyl, it is the portion of the embryo or seedling below the cotyledons. So you can see here this one. This portion which we can see is called hypocotyl, and it is the portion of embryo or seedling below the cotyledons. So you can see this portion is below the cotyledons, so it is called hypocotyl. And this portion which is above the cotyledons is called epicotyl. So what is epicotyl? The portion of embryo or seedlings above the cotyledons is called epicotyl. So there are two terms, hypocotyl and epicotyl. Hypo means below. The portion below the cotyledons is called hypocotyl, and epi means above. The portion above the cotyledons is called epicotyl. Okay kids, now let's summarize what we have learned up till now. First, we started with reproduction. So the process of creating more of their kind is known as reproduction. Plants reproduce by various ways. They are from seeds, from different parts of plant, and from spores. We have seen that plants give rise to flowers, flowers turn into fruits, and fruits contain seeds which will give rise to a new plant. Then we have seen structure of a seed. So a seed mainly is made up of, it has a seed coat which protects the seed from being damaged. Then it has seed leaves, or they are also called as cotyledons, which contain food supply for the baby plant. Seeds are of two types. So they are dicots, which has two cotyledons, or the ones which have only one cotyledon are called monocots. Example of dicots are kidney beans, while example of monocots are, example is a maize. Next, we have embryo, that is baby plant inside, it is called the embryo. Embryo has a shoot and a root. The shoot grows above the ground while root grows under the ground. Germination of seed. Germination, the definition, it is a process by which a seed produces a baby plant or seedling in the presence of water, air and warmth. Air is needed to breathe. Warmth makes the seed active. Water softens the seed coat so that the baby plant can break it open and come out, as well as water is needed to nourish the embryo. Next, we have seen different stages of seed germination. So in this, we have seen that the embryo root pushes the seed coat. It grows down into the soil and forms the roots. The cotyledons are pulled upwards. The baby plant called seedling starts coming out of the cotyledons. The stem grows above the soil and the leaves appear first. When the leaves develop completely, the cotyledons fall off, and thus the process of germination is completed. As well as we have seen two terms. The first term was hypocotyl. Hypo means below. Cotyl is the cotyledons. So the part below the cotyledons is called hypocotyl. While epicotyl, epi means above. Cotyl is again cotyledons. So the part above the cotyledons is called epicotyl. This is all that we have studied in this part.